The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily represent those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting group. Get involved with Access Fort Wayne and make your own television programming. Call 421-1250 to find out more.
Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree. These little children are asking you to please come out so we can play with you. Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on me. Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, hiding behind a tree. These little children are asking you to please come out so we can play with you. Oh, Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on, please shine down on, please shine down on me.
Hey,
catch
I heard
away.
A killer swell's hitting Africa. Grab your board. We're heading to the jungle.
Right on, bro. If there's waves, I'm there.
Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning
surfing
now.
Surprise.
Come on a safari with me.
Come on a safari with me.
Early in the morning, we'll be starting now. Some hunters will be coming along. We're loading up our woody with our boards inside. And we're heading out singing our song.
Now everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
Come on a safari with me.
In Huntington and Malibu, they're shooting the pier. In Rincon, they're walking the nose. We're going on safari to the islands this year. So if you're coming, get ready to go. Oh.
Come on, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Lonesome, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Surfing now, everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me. Now everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
Come on a safari.
Oh, they're angling in Laguna and Sarazul. They're kicking out in Doheny too. I tell you, surfing's one in one. It's getting bigger every day. From Hawaii to the shores of Peru.
Come on, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Lonesome, baby, wait and see. Yes, I'm gonna take you surfing with me. Surfing now, everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
Come on a safari with me.
Offshore winds and the waves are pumping. Check out those bros going for this manga wave.
Dude, that guy's hairy. Wait, that's a chimpanzee.
Yeah, you're smacking the lips. Hey, is that an elephant walking the nose?
You wouldn't see that in California. That looks like a wild boar.
Yay, he's hogging all the waves.
Whoa, is that a lion over there just the beach?
Yeah, man. Let's hit the water.
Cowabunga, dude!
Fact. In the Hawaiian language, the word Honolulu can be translated to sheltered bay or place of shelter, and you can give the city one look, you know why. Next song, Can't Stop the Feeling.
Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take you. Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama.
Key
Largo, Montego, baby, why don't we go? Jamaica.
Off the Florida Keys, there's a place called Coconut. That's where we wanna go to get away from it all. Bodies in the sand, tropical drink melting in your hand. We'll be falling in love to the rhythm of a steel drum band. Down in Kokomo,
Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take it. Bermuda, Bahama, come on, pretty mama. Key Largo, Montego, baby,
ooh, I wanna
go,
take
go.
It down to Kokomo. Looking out to sea, we'll perfect our chemistry. By and by we'll define a little bit of gravity. Afternoon delight, holding hands and moonlit nights. That dreamy look in your eye, give me a tropical tongue.
Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take it. Bermuda,
Surfing USA, and then we're having Jerry Armstrong.
Well, she got her daddy's car and she cruised to the hamburger stand now. Seems she forgot all about told her old man now. And with the radio blasting, goes cruising just as fast as she can now. And she'll have fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes the T-Bird away.
Fun, fun, fun till her daddy takes the T-Bird away.
The girls can't stand it cause she walks, looks and drives like an A-Star.
Walk like an A-Star, you walk like an A-Star.
She makes the Indy 500 look like a Roman chariot race now.
Wesley's TV, and at Wesley's TV, we're actually doing Hawaii this year. Look at this. Whoa, we get the Hawaiian shirts on. Okay, now at home, we're going to be doing some magic. So what I want you to do is find a deck of cards pretty quickly, and then we're going to do a trick for you here, okay?
So, okay.
You at home, go get your cards. And while you're doing that, I'll do a little something here. Okay, here's a dollar bill, okay? Okay, here's a dollar bill here, okay? And shouldn't normally do this, especially with all the virus going around, but I'm going to tear it here, okay? I'm going to tear it over here too, okay? Wow, okay, shouldn't do this either, okay? I can taste the mint. Yeah, okay. And then, dollars all back together, okay? Let's see, I'll do one more quick one while you guys are still getting your cards. Here's a regular rope. It doesn't have any trap doors or magnets or anything in it. And I'm going to tie it around my neck here. Okay. And then I'm going to tie it up here. Okay. When I first started doing this, see, magic is, you can do like a beginner's magic, a medium magic, or more experience. This is like a medium magic. One, two, there, goes through
went all the way through my neck. Now, you at home, you probably have your cards by now, right? Okay, what I want you to do is however many people's in your room, everybody gets a total of 9 cards. Take any 9 cards out of the deck, don't matter which 9 cards they are. Okay, this is an amazing phenomena that actually, if you were a card player, say back in the cowboy days, and you was able to, when doing poker with somebody, you could actually kind of figure out what someone else's cards is by doing this. You know, these cards have been around for like hundreds of years. They were designed perfectly when they were designed. Each deck of cards has 4 suits, okay? And they have 52 different cards, not including the jokers. Don't use the jokers in this either. Just take out the numbered cards. And each suit has 13 cards. That's a kind of scary number, isn't it? Yeah, but 13 is the number of each one of the suits. So, amazingly enough, of the 52 cards, each card knows its individual name. It really knows what it is. Just like you at home, and then like me, I have 3 names. Jerry, Michael, Armstrong, okay? Each card has 3 names to it. Okay, you got your 9 cards. What I want you to do is fan them out, look at them like this. Now, when you're looking at the cards, you can take any cards you want, okay? But just look at all 9 of them. And let's say, for instance, the 3rd card from the left. Don't take it out, but just memorize that card. Okay, know what that card is. Okay, and for instance, I'm going to tell you what mine is. Mine, the 3rd card from the left is the 8 of spades. Okay, there you go, 8 of spades. So you know what the 3rd card is. Okay, now close the deck up and put them on the table here. Now, just like I have my name with 3 names in it, Jerry, J-E-R-R-Y, this card was the 8 of spades. So your card would probably not be the 8 of spades. So spell it out like I'm doing. If you had a 7, S-E-V-E-N, if you had a 2, T-W-O, if you had an ace, it'd be A-C-E, a king, it'd be K-I-N-G, queen, Q-U-E-N-N-E. Okay, so I have an 8. E-I-G-H-T. Okay, so now you got yours spelled out. Now put your cards on top of those cards. The middle name is of. Okay, we all have the same middle name. O-F. So 8 of, then put those cards on top. Okay, and the last one would be spades for me. Whatever suit yours is, spell it out and add the S to it. Mine would be S-P-A-D-E-S, spades, okay. Then put those cards on top. Now, count off 4 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4. And your card should be the next card, 8 of spades. And your card should be actually be the card that you picked, okay? Because the cards do know their names. Okay, very good. Looks like I have time for maybe one more. Let's see. Okay. Take a look at this right here, okay? As you see, this one here is, find the camera, that's the right camera. This here is nothing, okay, now you switch cameras, okay. Now we're over here, nothing in the box, okay. Box is totally empty. I'll set the box right there. Now, what I'm going to do at home to have you choose a card, I'm gonna try and make it fair, so I'm gonna put these cards all around like this, okay, any which way, okay. Then I'm just gonna drop one card, and wherever it lands, that'll be the card we choose. Except we're on the floor, okay? Okay, drop it. I guess it'd be closest over here. Let's say this would be our card. 3 of diamonds, okay? I'm gonna write TV card on this. There we go. This would be our card, the TV card, okay? There you go, oh, there you go, TV card, okay. Now I'm gonna put it back in the deck here. we go. It's all back in the deck. Put it here, and now I'm going to shuffle the cards. Watch where I shuffle, okay? Okay. Okay. Magicians are supposed to be very fast. I'm going to see if I can actually find your card. We'll see how fast I can find it. And back here, bingo. It's done, okay? I think I found the card already. It should be right here, which, yes, it is. Okay, it's right on top. Okay, let's do that one more time. Shuffle them up.
It's from the green screen.
Oh. I'll drop one, but don't worry about it. Okay, I'll put it behind my back, see if I can find that card again. I'm having a little harder time this time finding that card. Let's see, but I think I got it. Yeah. Okay, I got it. Okay, now your card should be right on top. It's not the three that we wanted. Okay, see if that's it. No, so here's that empty box we had right here, okay? I'm gonna put the lid on this empty box, okay? Just like so. Okay. Okay. Now, is that the right card? No, that's not the right card. Okay. I have an out in case that happens. I have an out in case that happens. Let's put these cards down here, okay? And let's take this box and look. Inside the box, there is actually a card. But is that your card? No more card in the box. And it turned out to be, yes, the TV card, three of diamonds, ended up in that box. Okay, thank you very much. And here we are in Hawaii, and I hope you can come here with us. Okay, talk to you later. Oh, and I have my show. It comes on, it's called Jerry Street Magic. It comes on every Friday night at 6:30 or 2:30 a.m. and Saturday morning, or 10:30. Saturday morning. So tune into my show, Jerry Street Magic. Thank you very much. See you later.
I hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream in my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame excess. Whoa. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Looked to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy, everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio and a Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. In my taxi cab, everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She's gotta be from out of town. So hard with my girls not around me. It's definitely not a Nashville party. Cause all I see is stilettos. I guess I never got the memo. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the DJ dropped my
Fun fact about Hawaii. Barack Obama is the only president from outside of the continental United States. Now, the song is Get the Party Started, Kids. Bop Party hits track number two.
Get the party started.
Okay, fun fact. Hawaii Five-O was the longest-running police drama until Law and Order. While the stars worked for the state police department in the series, in reality, Hawaii doesn't have a statewide police department or DMV. They are managed by each county government. Okay, the next song is Who Let the Dogs Out? Kid Bop Party Hits track number 10.
Welcome to Wesley TV. We are back. Okay, as I was saying, I looked a little bit different there for a moment. But we are here at Wesley TV. We are finally back, as what I quoted when I got in the studio and did a video, home where I belong. This is my second home. Should be my second home, but another place is mine for right now. But anyways, welcome to Wesley TV. We are back in the studio. We are happy. We are happening. And I'm looking good. I'm wearing blue. I don't know. But anyways, I'm Jeff Landis. If you don't know who I am, then you're at the wrong station, the wrong channel, in the wrong city. A couple months ago on Wesley TV, I said I got some shock value. You're going to see it August 6th. That's all I'm saying. But anyways, my special guest this evening is...
Hey, I'm Taylor Royce, the 5-time Ukasakon champion. I've acquired 3 blue ribbons last year, back in 2019. What else did I have? I've got a whole list of awards to list. So that's who I am. Your 5-time Ukasakon champion, Taylor Royce.
Nice. We got an award-winning person in the studio today. So you also do TV shows here on Access as well?
Yes, I do. I produce my own television show called Heart of Japan. It is a cosplay and video gaming television program. We do things like the Candy Coffin, which we're going to show up. I do other art like buttons, make costumes for all sorts of different things. All of this has been like non-professional stuff, just for fun, just to make some art, do things like that. But you can always catch my TV show, new episodes airing, because I finally just got a TV time slot this year. It's Thursdays at 10 p.m. right here on Access Fort Wayne. So a lot of our stuff is TV 14, TVMA. We do some PG-rated stuff, but generally it's TV 14, TVMA for the teens and older stuff, because I'm older than a teen, so it's what I like to produce and what I like to show off. So that's
nothing wrong with that. You know, we got different producers doing all kinds of different things. I've been doing TV since I was 14, so I like to push the button as well. That's what I'm gonna be doing here pretty soon. Yeah. But what made you decide, hey man, I want to do my own TV show? And how did you get directed to Access Fort Wayne?
Well, it was years ago, and I was like, grew up watching TV for so long. Most of the time, I've, you know, started making, back like when I was getting towards the end of high school, making AMVs, anime music videos. You can catch a lot of my work, not all of my work, but some of my work. You can catch it on my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com. If we could get those up on the screen, people could jot it down. It's youtube.com/c/ Mr. Mudkips, all one word, super simple to remember. And that's where you can watch my AMVs and stuff like that. Generally, I don't show those on TV. Some stuff's for YouTube, some stuff's for TV. But I was doing YouTube stuff, and I was making videos every so often. And I'm like, well, if I watch TV so often, why not make TV? So I wanted to get, came down to the library and saw that they had a TV station right here in the library, which I think is pretty amazing. So I just asked a few questions. They're like, $5 for the class, you get your $5 at the end of the class. So I'm like, why not do it? I went through all the classes, learned all this stuff, and here I am making my own TV show. Either in studio or at home, either one. Generally, we've been making stuff at home with, you know, the all virus going around and everything.
That's crazy.
It's just so much easier to just aim the camera at the TV screen, aim a camera on me, and do a picture-in-picture style television show. Super simple. You know, people want to see what's on the TV screen most often, and I can just clip in however long the segments I want to. If I need to take a break, hey, we're taking a break, bam, and then just hard cut the next segment in. It's that simple. So, you know, making television isn't rocket science. It's more of an art form, and once you learn your style of art, how you want to make that art, it's so much easier to get your ideas on the screen.
Oh yeah, for sure. Like I said, I consider, you know, doing TV shows like having a kid. Because, you know, you're producing your own thing, and when people like it, and they watch it, and they keep going, it makes you want to do it more and more. If that makes any sense.
Yeah, definitely.
So what made you, how long have you been doing it, actually?
About what? Doing what?
Your TV show.
How long?
Yeah.
I think we started making episodes back in, I want to say, like, 2013, 2014 was when I first started doing stuff.
Yeah.
And from time to time, I start to bring back clips from the very early episodes. I had a co-host, Myla Modisit, and she I met her from the anime conventions in town. And I started progressing more and more awards, I was like, started evolving. How do I want my TV show to evolve over the years and stuff? And now that I've acquired a second camera, it's so much easier to do picture-in-picture style stuff. And it's just so much simpler to just do things at home with all the virus and the social distancing and all this going around. It's just so much easier to throw a video game up on the TV screen and just film it.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what I like to do. A variety of different video games, ranging from like Blair Witch to Senran Kagura to Pokemon to almost, you know, a variety of stuff. Pinball, a lot of virtual pinball, which if you watch the Fantasticon 2019 documentary, then you'll see a lot of real life pinball. And then we kind of have moved since we don't have real life pinball machines take up a lot of space. We got a lot of virtual pinball on the Nintendo Switch that we'd like to do. I like to do on my TV show as well. So keep it variety for different people. It's like when I work in the kitchen, I work in culinary professionally. So when, and I've got my culinary awards and medals and stuff like that for my work. But when you're making something in the kitchen, you're going to find people every day that love your food, and you're going to find people that hate your food. It's a mixed batch, especially where I work. I work at a college, so to each their own taste buds. I love sour food. I hate spicy food.
Yeah.
So I tend to stay away, and when I make my culinary food, I stay away from a lot of spicy stuff. I mean, not to say I don't make spicy food. Well, I make spicy food on occasion, but I won't usually eat it.
Right, yeah.
But I like to make things with like citrus ranch or sauces or things like that. Different sloppy Joe recipes, things like that. So and you can't please everybody all the time.
That
so you
true.
Might as well please as many people as you can, as best as you can, because those who aren't going to be pleased just aren't going to be pleased. So what? Go move on with life. Those that are being pleased, you know, take pride in that and enjoy the ones that you did know that you did please certain people throughout the day, because you're not going to be able to please everyone with your art. It's just, that's how it is with art, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's what it is. What you're doing with TV is creating your own art. And again, I get what you're saying. Again, like I said, you're doing something that nobody else is doing on, you know, any kind of TV show right now. You know, you're doing something different. People like the different mix of everything, like you were saying before. Now, you said you have some art stuff that you want to show us today on Wesley TV?
Yeah, I actually had a bunch of buttons, and I have actually this right here is the candy coffin. If you want to get a close-up of that, here's the candy coffin right here. It's I'm going to set the mic down for a second.
Oh, you're good.
Here's the candy coffin. So here's my little jingle, folks. 1, 2, 3, 4, I open the door to candy. Two candy. Okay. Cha-ching! What's in it today? Oh, look at what we got. We've got two different flavors of Hi-Chews in it. We've got grape, and we got green apple. So I'm going to try a grape one. Whichever one you want to try, Jeff, take your pick. Yeah.
Green apple.
Yeah. So this is a Japanese, pretty traditional. It's a pretty traditional Japanese candy that you find a lot of times at conventions, anime conventions, all the time. They're just ramen is the standard drink you're gonna find at your anime convention. These are probably your standard snack you're gonna find at anime conventions, and inside this little pouch right here is a bunch of buttons. So I started getting into making actually. Here's a nice button, and I started making holographic buttons. So it's hard to see with the glare of the lights and stuff. And I got a camera in my way, but that's okay. There's that one. There's one of something from Mega Man. And let me see if I can find. Here's a Mega Man button. Speaking of Mega Man. I made a Mega Man button. I got a whole series. This one's Battletoads. It's got a little bit of holographicness to the edges. Let me find one that has a lot of holographic on it. There's a couple of these. Here's one. Here we go. This is a good one.
You want me to zoom in on his buttons?
Oh, that's a pretty cool one.
Yeah, this one's Rayquaza. This is what I got an award for back in 2018. Right here at the library, the Cherry Blossom Festival. I think that's the biggest festival that's held here at the library, the Cherry Blossom Festival.
I think so. I've never been to it, but I've seen Wesley film it, and I've seen some other people film it, too.
Yeah, and I got first place in 2018 with Confetti Blasting Rayquaza. So that's a good one. I got, like, a good, like, 70 buttons made. Not all of them are perfect, but I learned how to use a button press and started making... Most of these are just taken from magazines, actually, if you believe it or not. Most of these are just magazine pictures that I cut out and I traced and cut out and made into buttons. And just every so often I grab a bunch of buttons. And then, you know, I figured out how to make the holographic buttons by taking some gift wrapping paper from the dollar store. And you get a huge sheet for like a dollar. And you layer your picture on top of your holographic paper. And then you put your plastic sheet on top, and then you press down, and you got a button, a holographic button with more. I think there's one in here that's got this one, right? Which one? This one.
He's doing this bag of goodies.
Yeah, look at that one.
Oh, that's awesome. I like that. Yeah. The shine. And...
Yeah, this one is super holographic. You can tell. Ooh, yeah. That's a good one.
Oh, yeah, for sure. You know, I was just thinking as you were doing this, you know, have you ever thought about marketing your show by making buttons of your show, like advertising for it,
you know,
and putting like shirts and stuff like that? Because that's what I do.
I don't know. Because over the years, I developed my brand name, I guess you'd say, as Squid Lips Production Studios, which you can go to squidlipstv.wixsite.com/studios to find out contests and art like that. Speaking of contests, I got an AMV contest going on. If you haven't seen the promo for that, the short little promo here on Access Fort Wayne, that's going on right now. That's a YouTube contest for my subscribers on YouTube to win trophies this year. It's my second YouTube contest that I've done. I did one back in 2010, about 10 years ago, same thing, but this one's for my subscribers to win trophies this year, upping the ante a little bit, making it more fun for people since all the conventions and everything have shut down. I figured it's a little way to give back to the people that have subscribed to me on YouTube and stuff. So
that's understandable. Yeah, this whole social distancing thing is crazy, but I'm glad we get to be back in the studio.
Yeah, it is nice.
Yeah, it's crazy, but... So your show is called I Love something in Japan, right?
Heart of Japan.
Heart of Japan. Have you ever thought about eventually going down there to travel to do a show?
I thought about it a couple times. I think that would be so much work to travel over there, to bring the cameras and being the producer and the host of the show. I never really initially wanted to be the host or even really in front of camera.
You want to be behind the scenes?
Yeah, I want to be behind the scenes doing. I'd rather have someone else host the show. But since I started hosting the show, because it's easier, it's one less person I got to take care of, one less person to manage. It's easier to control what's on the show if I'm the host of the show doing the show. So I figured, you know, I might not have the best on camera presence. I have more of an artistic style to be behind the camera as a producer, but I figured since I started being in front of the camera, I figured I'd start filming myself competing and winning awards and doing that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So with like 2018 getting the Cherry Blossom Festival win and then 2019 taking home second place at Fantasticon with my confetti blasting go-kart and that kind of stuff. I've just started it's a way to record some of my winning events and then showing it for forever for those who want to see it can watch it anytime, you know. I need to go through my footage and get back the second half of that cosplay contest from 2018. If I can edit, I got the first 20 minutes, but if I can edit in the second segment, I need to do that. If I can find it and I got the results on my YouTube channel as well.
That's
but
cool.
Yeah, I took home 5 awards from IkazuCon, started in 2010, and then I had 3 years in a row, 12, 13, 14, and then 17. So 5 awards in 8 years. That's pretty dang good for, for at the same convention. That's pretty unheard of.
Now I'm getting a wrap from the back. Okay. Before we go, anything to say to the fans out there to subscribe to you, push and promote your show?
Just if you love anime and cosplay and video game footage, you know, you want to see the best in the world of that, then check out Heart of Japan. Go to my YouTube channel, youtube.com/C/MrBudKips. And remember, folks, don't yuck someone else's yum.
I agree with that. I'm about to subscribe to his channel, actually. So I will see you guys later. Thank you for watching Wesley TV. Thanks for coming on.
Hey, thanks for having me.
No problem. Welcome to Wesley TV. Here I am, Jeff Landis, along with, who am I on the phone with?
Caleb Owen.
So how you doing, man?
I'm doing wonderful.
Same here, just tired, but I'm doing good. I'm managing. So you couldn't manage to be here on in person. Why? Where are you located at?
I'm located in Castleton, Indiana, in Indianapolis.
Nice. Can you walk here? It might take you a little bit, but by the time we get here, the studio would be done and empty.
Yeah.
Right. So tell us a little bit about you, about your backstory, how you and Wesley met and stuff.
We met in, what would you say, Wesley, in elementary school? Something.
Yeah,
he's
saying, yeah, in elementary school you guys met.
Yeah, and we've been friends for a few years now.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So what do you think about Wesley and his accomplishments, you know, from what he's done from doing TV and stuff like that?
I mean, I knew that he liked doing TV shows because me and him would play around, like, pretend we were having in elementary school, we'd play and pretend we were having our own TV show.
Nice.
But I didn't know he was actually going to do it.
Right. Do you have any goals that you would like to accomplish in your life with things? You know, like said, Wesley did a couple of his things with TV and stuff like that. Is there anything that you would like to accomplish that you could, because I know you could do it, man. All you got to do is have heart and soul and dedication to what you want to do. Anything you want to do?
I mean, I want to be like a musician, like play guitar for people and be a DJ and stuff like that.
Well, you know, you could, I've got people on my friends list that if you want to talk to about doing stuff with radio, and they got a radio station down here as well, but you also try to do internet radio as well. I've got people I can contact with you, send me a message on Facebook and I'll get you contacted with them, the way you can do something with DJing or whatever.
Oh, that'd be great.
You know, all it takes is yourself to go for your goal if you want it and go for it. And like I said, just ask Wes. So like I said, he's a good kid. Yeah, I think the last time we seen you was it Christmas Fest that he was there? Christmas Fest?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, Christmas Fest.
Yeah, with my girl, me and...
When do you plan on coming back to Fort Wayne to come and visit us?
I mean, hopefully soon, but this coronavirus has been a problem. I'm thinking about it as soon as possible, but with the pandemic...
Yeah, it's crazy, man. A lot of things change.
Yep.
We never thought that. I never thought 2020 that this stuff would happen. But
and especially for this long, I've been out of work for 5, 6, 7 months now.
Yeah, I returned back in May, and they keep talking about things shutting down again. I hope not, because it's crazy. You know, we gotta live our lives, but you know, we gotta be safe as well.
Yeah, they're talking about a phase 2.
Yeah, I know around India area it's getting worse from what people are saying. But again, like I said, I mean, I watch the stuff. But again, like I said, it's just crazy on how, you know, it takes one simple virus to keep us away from doing stuff that we love.
Yeah.
And I'm grateful to be back here in the TV studio. It's an awesome feeling. Well, hopefully you get to see you again, man. Anything you would say to anybody out there that's watching the show? To Wesley, anybody?
I would just say, hopefully you guys have a safe holiday and stuff, and hopefully we get the Three Rivers Festival back on.
Man, I know it feels different without it, because I normally take my kids there every year, and yeah, now it's like, what to do next?
Yeah.
But all right, well, good talking to you as always. Like I said, hit me up later on if you want to. Hit me up probably after 4 or 5 when I get off work or something, and I'll connect you to some DJs that I know, and maybe they can help you get on their radio or something like that.
All right. That sounds good.
All right. Well, good talking to you. Have a good day. And thank you for coming on Wesley TV.
Thank you.
All right. You're welcome. All right, bye. Great exclusive interview from Caleb.
Who let the dogs out? That's Scruffy. Get that, you flea infested mongrel. I'm gonna tell myself I'm a no get angry. Hi-ya.
Yippee-i-yo.
To any girls, call him the canine. Hey,
yippee-i-yo.
Tell Gummy, hey man, it's part of the party.
Yippee-i-yo.
Put your left leg in front and right leg behind. Is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold it.
A doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold it. Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? That's Scruffy. Get that, you flea infested mongrel. Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my groove, cause my mind done gone. Do you see the rays coming from my eye? Walking through the place, I did you manage breaking it down? See in my white George shorts, and I can't see color. Any color will do. I'm stuck on you, that's why they call me Pitbull. Cause I'm the man of the land. When they see me, they say, oh.
Back.
It's a beautiful day out.
Yeah.
The snow falls white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say.
Let's start waiting on.
The cold never bothered me anyway. It's funny how some distance makes everything seem small. And the fears that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free.
soul, this spiraling in frozen fractals all around. My one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. I'm never going back, the past is in the cold never bothered me anyway.
www.burnsville.org/traffic.